Some of the guns that I make videos with, I really, really like. But some of them totally blow.
It's an air gun.
Welcome to Demolition Ranch. When I think of an air rifle, I think of a BB gun or a pellet gun. You know, something for like a young kid to learn how to shoot. Maybe go shoot a bird or a squirrel or something, and that's about it. Or maybe like a airsoft gun that, you know, you shoot at your buddy and no one dies. That is definitely not what this gun is. It's not a BB gun. It's not an airsoft gun. This is like a pretty powerful gun. This is actually called a Dragon Claw, made by Sam Yang, which is Korean, I'm pretty sure. I got this off airgundepot.com, and this is what they call a big bore air gun. It shoots a 50 caliber bullet, which is crazy. These guns are used for small game. They're also used for like whitetail deer. You can actually take down a deer where legal with an air rifle, which is nuts, because I never thought of them as being that powerful. I need to fill this thing up. This will be the first time I've ever done it. It actually has a gauge here, and it came, focus on that, focus, you can do it. There we go. It came with a little bit of air in it. You can see that we are just getting into the yellow. So I think it's got air. Basically, it holds air in these two bottom tubes. The top one is the barrel where the 50 cal bullet shoots out. So I'm gonna use this big fill tank right here, which I went and got filled, and try to pump this thing up. I don't know how. Yeah, just like a standard thing, okay. And I guess I need to look at this gauge as I'm doing this and make sure I don't put too much in. I don't know. I can't do it with one hand. All right, we are filling. Oh yeah, cool. I don't know if you guys can see that, the gauge is up. I went all the way to red. That took like hardly any air at all. Now you can see we are in the green, not into the red yet. I guess it's ready to put a bullet in there, which I think you do right here, yeah. So both these bullets are 50 caliber. This one is a hollow point, 180 grain. This one is obviously not, but it does have a steel tip. It's 200 grain. Let's do it. I'm gonna shoot a hollow point first. No idea how I'm supposed to do this. So this gun is just a single shot rifle. That doesn't seem right. Okay. So now the air tanks are full and we have a bullet loaded in the chamber. I think you just cock it, and there's apparently two positions here. One for low power, one for high. I think that's the low power. I think I went back halfway. I'm gonna shoot this thing with no ear protection on, just cause I wanna see how loud or quiet it is. Hopefully that's not a mistake. We have a target at 25 yards. Whoa, that was cool. A little bit too loud for shooting without ear protection on, but not nearly as loud as a gun. And hopefully you guys can tell that, because that ring was super, super loud because that 50 cal bullet hit it. There's our hit right there. Very cool. Now that I know the sights are on, I went ahead and moved the target back another 15 yards, so we're probably around 40 yards now. What's really cool about this air gun, and all air guns, is that the ATF, the organization that makes all the laws for firearms in the United States, does not actually classify this as a gun. Even though it shoots a projectile capable of taking down a deer, it's not a firearm, which means that you don't have to abide by firearms laws, which means that I can order it online and they can just ship it to my house, which means that there's no short barrel rifle laws, so you can have as short or as long of a rifle as you want, which also means it can be fully automatic, just like an airsoft gun can. It's just a big airsoft gun, even though it's not shooting anything soft. So you can have a fully automatic gun that shoots lead, but without gunpowder, and it's legal if they made that, which they should. Someone should make that. So this time I'm going with some ear protection because it wasn't super loud. It was about like a silenced rifle, which is not crazy loud, but it still doesn't feel good on your ears. We're gonna do the 200 grain with a little steel tip this time. Speaking of silencers, you could put silencers on these guns. You could make them even quieter than they already are, because they're not firearms. They're just air rifles. It's pretty cool. This time I'm gonna go back all the way. So that first click is for low power. Now we're doing high power. It's noticeably quieter when you have earmuffs on than a regular firearm. We are at 160 right now. I'm gonna fire one high power round out of it and we'll see how much it drops. Because obviously it can't hold pressure forever. So yeah, 120, 40, yeah, we're at 160 right now. High power. Now, I'm like at 150. Focus, focus, you can do it. This camera's focused. There you go, 150. So you get quite a few shots. The reason it has red, green, and yellow is because you don't want to be overpowered and in the red, and you don't want to be underpowered in the yellow. It'll still shoot, but you're not going to get the same velocity, so it's going to be dropping way quicker. I'm going to see how fast I can shoot 5 bullets out of this gun. I have 4 in my hand, 1 in the chamber. We're just going for speed, not necessarily accuracy. Let's see how fast we can do this. That's a hit. This is hard. This is like muzzle loader. It's not that hard. There's another hit. Another hit. If I can get 5 for 5, that'd be crazy. But I probably just jinxed myself. Last one. Don't mess this up, Matt, like you mess up everything in your life. Woo. Woo. Yes. Not the fastest, but not too bad either. And let's see. After those 5, oh my gosh, this focus is gonna kill me. Just focus on it. It's almost in the yellow. Just take my word for it, guys. You really need me to prove this? There we go. Almost in the yellow. So we started just below the top of the green, and now we're just above the bottom of the green. So you probably get about 10 shots in that green range before it starts dropping off. Found some of the pieces of lead under that metal target. They're all just totally smushed. As soon as they hit that steel, they just flattened out and got really, really wide. I'm gonna fill up again because now I'm gonna shoot at some targets. See how much damage this thing does. This thing is loaded with air. I'm gonna put a hollow point in here, and then I have a full water jug over there that I'm gonna shoot it at on high power. I wanna see 2 things. I wanna see if I can find the bullet afterwards to see if it expands that hollow point at all. I would assume it does not, just because I don't think the velocity is high enough, but maybe it will. I also just wanna know what happens to the water jug. Does it just poke a hole and go through? Or does it explode it? I don't think it's gonna explode it. We'll know in a second. Wow, it's actually a lot better than I thought it was gonna be. Here's our water jug. Do we have a bullet in it? Nope. So, wow. So we came in right there. That is our entry hole. There was so much pressure, it popped the top off, which it usually does. It also cracked this right here. There's a big hole there. And then it came through the back right there and also busted out the back. So, looks like we need to put 2 water jugs in a row. See if we can catch that bullet. Probably hard to see for you guys, but there are 2 water jugs there lined up in a row. So, hopefully we can catch this thing. Looks like we hit both. All right, let's see. Maybe that's actually the entry hole. So maybe on that other one, that big hole was the entry hole, and that was an exit hole. Because I think it was, because it was turned this way. And then, dang it, it went through this one too. So went in the second one, came out the back there. Man, I just want to find that bullet, but not looking like it's going to happen today. I did not bring any more water jugs out here, but I did bring a watermelon. And I'm going to shoot it with one of these steel tipped from fairly close range. That was cool.
There's our entry hole, and there's our exit hole. Pretty cool.
When you shoot these watermelons with a pistol, it usually does that. When you shoot them with a rifle, it explodes because rifles have so much more energy. So this air rifle has kind of the energy of a pistol. I just filled up the air tank again. I'm gonna walk down to the creek and fire some long distance. I'm using the creek just because I'll be able to see kind of how far they go. I watched a video that Iraq veteran made with not this gun and not a 50 caliber, but a similar big bore air gun, and he shot at like 440 yards and it would have gone a lot further too if he had the range. So I know these things can go pretty far. We probably have about 200 yards of straight creek right here, so we'll be able to see it hit the water quite a distance away. We're here now and I just saw a snake. It like crawled right over my foot, and as I'm saying that, I realize I'm gonna get lots of Toy Story quotes. So go ahead, get it out of your system. We're gonna be shooting straight down this creek. This is the round nose. Safety off. Didn't make it all the way down there. Hope you guys can see this. That was probably about maybe a little over 100, maybe 125 yards. This is a hollow point. Just putting whatever comes out of my pocket in there. That was about as far as we're gonna be able to shoot. Hope you guys can see that on this camera. It's clear as day out here because it's splashing that water. That was right at the end there. That one definitely hit rock. Pretty good splash. This thing really doesn't recoil very much either. I'll shoot it like this so you can see. Has a very, very small kick to it. Any kid could shoot this thing, no problem. Not very loud. No recoil at all, just have one hand and a finger on it. Easy. Now I have something super cool that I want to show you that you can do with this air rifle. What's up? Not much, just about to set up my bow and arrow targets. From my bow, of course. No way. It shoots arrows. These arrows are specifically designed to be shot out of this gun. They call them air bolts. For those who don't know, compound bows shoot arrows pretty hard, but crossbows shoot them even harder, really hard, like way harder. This is going to go as fast as a crossbow can shoot. So this thing is as powerful, if not more powerful, than the most powerful crossbow. And let me just show you the back of it here with a bullet in comparison, so you can see kind of how it works. That's the back of the arrow. You can see that it is the same as the back of a bullet. This camera sucks at focusing. So I assume you just sort of put it in here and twist the fins all one direction. So there's the tip of the arrow sticking out. Go ahead and close this port. I think it should be ready to go. Safety off. I filled this tank up so we have a fresh tank. Let's see what we can do here. Whoa! It went straight through that thing and launched out the back. Arrows out of my compound bow will stick in that thing, and they're skinnier and they still will stick. That thing went straight through because it was going so fast.
There's my truck. There's the arrow target I was shooting at. And way over here is our arrow. Tip's still good. Looks like we lost the part that sits behind the arrow. I'll shoot another one and see if these are a one-time firing thing or if you can shoot them more than once.
I was aiming at the center bullseye I hit right there. You can see that hole's bigger than the others. And it came out right here. You can notice there's no other exit wounds because I've never actually had an arrow go all the way through this thing. It's a lot of power, a lot of speed. It spins as it goes down with the rifling. It's kind of cool. Okie dokie. Safety again. That one may have stuck. I didn't see it fly out.
Cool. Nice kill.
My computer monitor on my main editing computer is out, so I'm gonna shoot an arrow through it. That looks so cool.
Looks like it may need another arrow.
There's something very satisfying about sticking an arrow into one of those old school computer monitors.
Nice.
Thanks for being here with me today, and thanks to our friends at Air Gun Depot for showing me that these guns even exist. But I guess they don't really exist because the ATF doesn't classify them as guns. So they're kind of like ghost guns. That's pretty cool. Go get yourself a shirt at magpul.com/demoranch. Go get your friend a shirt too, and your mom a shirt, and your brother needs a shirt. And if I ever see anyone wearing my shirts, I'll walk up to you and I'll give you a hug. That's my promise to you. Thanks for watching Demolition Ranch, and I will see you next time.
Contact.
That's a great idea. What about the quad hog?
Bobby! I'm a doctor. Ish.